walking around, you got $1,000 in your pocket, $10,000 in your bank account, writing a check, dollar. It costs more for the paper than what you're putting in the offering. God said, I wanted to cost you something. Oh, yeah. Not just your money. I want your worship to cost you something. I want when you leave here, folk know you've been in worship. So many of us, this is how we come to worship. We come in cool and we leave. It ain't cost you. And then we want to know why we don't have the power of God on our lives. Everything God did cost him something. Oh, yes, it did. Yeah, it cost him. And if you want to know how much it costs, you got to pick up the life of Jesus. It cost God everything. For God so loved the world that he gave. That is, it cost him something. Yeah. Come on now, y'all. Let's get this all called. Put it down. And come on, give me some celebration, because this is my glory that you're carrying home. Oh, look at it now. Look at it. They were only about 14 miles from Jerusalem. Six steps at every sacrifice was a long time. They could have gotten back in a few hours, but it's projected it took over a month to get back because they were so busy celebrating and sacrificing that it took them longer than they expected. But when David saw in the distance the mountain of Zion, the holy hill of Zion, Jerusalem, oh my God, he saw his palace, and to the entry gates were closed. And when David said, pick up that ark, and they started walking, David started saying, lift up your heads, all ye gates, and be ye lifted up, ye everlasting doors. And the folk on the inside said, who is the King of glory? David said, the Lord, strong and mighty, the Lord, mighty in battle. Hey, 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 look at them now. The gates are swinging open. The gates are being pushed back by the men to let the King of glory come in. And when David got into that gate, he started saying, enter his gates with thanksgiving, his courts with praise. Be thankful and bless his name, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. His truth endures to all generations. I'm just about to. But something happened. While they were shouting, David started dancing. David started dancing all over the place. Yes, he was. And while he was dancing, Micah was looking, hand on hip, looking out the window. Look at the king. Ought to be ashamed of himself. He's the king. He brought the United Kingdoms together. This man wears robes, gold on his wrist, on his finger, a crown on his head. Why is he acting so undignified, distinguishing himself and being nothing but a fool? But while Michael was despising, David was dancing. Hey, I need to tell you something. When folk start despising your dance, you better keep on dancing. When people say, don't take all of that. When folk say you're acting stupid, when they say that, just keep on dancing. When death takes a loved one, when sickness ravages your body and you can't hear the music, just keep on dancing.